The typical application of reinforcement learning is in cases where the environment is only partially known. And to get information about the reward policy and about the state change policy, we will need to explore. And once we explore the environment, we are going to learn differences between the current state and the new state we get through exploration. And that's going to lead to this sort of temporal difference learning algorithms. And that's what we're going to discuss in a series of lectures starting from this one. And the point is that when you don't know the state change, you don't know the reward policy of the environment, we say that we are in a model-free learning, and this is opposed to the topic that we discussed in the previous lecture on model-based learning. Now, in this case, where we don't have a model, we have to learn the environment through exploration. And what this means really is that you are sampling from the probability distribution of the state change and the probability distribution for the reward function. And we will see how to use the reward received in the next time step to update the value of the current state. And that's what you get through choosing an action to update the state. And this temporal difference between the value of the current action and the value discounted from the next state is going to be at the basis of our learning algorithm. There are two main types of exploration strategies, one based on a greedy strategy and the other one based on a probabilistic approach. In the greedy strategy, the point is that you will have a threshold epsilon, and in each state you are going to decide with probability epsilon to explore and with probability 1 minus epsilon to exploit. Now, exploring, it means that you are going to choose one action at random uniformly. So all the actions have a chance to be selected no matter the reward they offered in the past. Each one of them is going to have a chance, and that corresponds to our idea of exploring our options and learning about the effect of new possible actions. And with the exploiting option, we are going to choose the best action we got so far in terms of the reward we got in response of that action. With respect to the probabilistic approach, the point here is that we are going to use the softmax function. We already have some knowledge. Maybe for some of them the knowledge is zero, but for some other ones we have some knowledge about the reward they are offering. So we have this internal or partial information about the internal reward functions, and we are going to choose the actions somehow according to the internal rewards. So in state S, the probability of selecting action A is going to be given by the softmax function. We have the internal rewards partial information about these internal rewards on state S with action A, and we combine all of these internal rewards into these probabilistic values via the softmax function. And the other idea I want to pass in regard with exploration strategies is that you want to have a sort of a dynamic strategy. You want in the beginning to be able to explore more so that you are increasing your knowledge base about the rewards of various actions. And then later on, so that you are encouraging convergence of your algorithm, you are going to want to exploit more and give less options for exploration. And so we have this smooth move from exploration to exploitation. And we can do this in the following way. If you are going for the epsilon greedy, the idea is very simple. Just start with an epsilon that is relatively large, so closer to 1, and just decrease it as you are going ahead through your learning. So decrease epsilon as you are advancing through the learning algorithm. For the probabilistic approach, the idea is that we are going to use the concept of an annealing algorithm. And the concept is simple. We are going to use a so-called temperature parameter And this temperature parameter is passed on to the softmax function in the exponent in this way. It's going to be a division of the internal rewards to this temperature variable. And the point is that when t is large, all probabilities are equal and we will get exploration. On the other hand, when t is small, it's the better actions that are going to be favored. So the strategy is going to start with a large temperature variable and decrease it gradually, and this is exactly what the annealing procedure stands for. And so for us, this is going to mean a move, a smooth move from exploration to exploitation as you are advancing through your learning algorithm.